Chronicle Books presents How We Heal, Uncover Your Power and Set Yourself Free. Written by Alexandra Elle. Read by author. For my readers, when we heal ourselves, we heal our lineage. Healing is an act of community care. For my daughters, I love you beyond words. You are the reason I heal. Author's note: Why We Heal. For years, I've been teaching folks from all walks of life how to use writing as a way to heal. I've led self-care workshops throughout the world, and I've helped thousands of people on their healing journeys. And yet, this book almost didn't happen. My self-doubt and imposter syndrome were intense. I found myself stuck in a negative thought spiral, asking myself questions like, "Who do you think you are? What makes you think you're qualified to write this? You're no therapist, no doctor, no scholar with a research background. Your experience is not enough." With that negative self-talk in tow, I would go to my computer and try my hand at writing a book about healing and self-discovery and self-trust. Every time I sat down to write, my eyes would burn. My heart would beat fast and my palms would sweat. Anxiety would win time and time again. Most days, walking away felt safer than trying. As I walked away, my self-doubt would say, "See, you're a quitter. That's why this isn't for you. You're not really made for this work." Wow, intense, right? The stories we tell ourselves can make or break us. As I start to peel back the layers of why I was trying to talk myself out of writing this book, I begin to realize I was concerned about the wrong thing. I was too concerned that my experience isn't enough when it absolutely is. And while I may not have a degree in psychology or a full-time research job, I have real life lived under my belt. I've been hurt, and I've been healed. That counts for something. I realize my role is to help people show up authentically in their healing in ways that leave them better than they were before listening to this audiobook. I'm sharing this story because I know for a fact that we all have some moments of doubting who we are or even forgetting who we are and how far we've come. Sometimes we are our harshest critic. Each of us, at one point in time, has made up stories in our head about who we aren't instead of focusing on the good of who we are. Maybe you're listening to this and thinking, "Someone has actually told me those negative things about myself and my capabilities, and I believed them." No matter where your small self-view comes from, you must remember that in healing and releasing untrue stories and outside projections, shrinking and walking away won't serve you. Healing requires us to get in touch with our true selves, and that, my friends, requires us to show up and be big. I've been working on my inner critic in therapy for a couple of years now, and healing that part of my mind that tells me I'm not good enough is a work in progress. I know I'm not alone there. I've had the honor of facilitating thousands of people on their writing to heal journeys. The expansive way that people have showed up on the pages of their journals blew my mind each and every time. I saw that, through writing, people could take an honest look at their pain in a way that they never could before. Everyone says the same thing. "I want to find myself, heal my heart, and let go of the things that are getting in the way of that." But so often, people choose not to look at their emotional wounds, traumas, and shortcomings because they don't know how to heal themselves after uncovering the mess. I get that. I turned away from my pain for years. Turning away led to a lot of destructive behaviors like self-harm, anxiety, depression, and having a child at 18 because I was looking for love, comfort, and attention in all the wrong places. Healing what tears us open is challenging, but possible work. Humans are complicated and flawed. I'd like us to normalize that and be open to greeting our fear and imperfections right where they are. My own healing journey has been rooted in writing to heal. the practice of using writing to unpack my baggage, process my deep emotions, and create a new narrative for my life. In my personal practice, writing shapes me, and it continues to be my permission to show up flawed and unsure while holding space for gratitude, potential, and the recognition of how far I've come. Writing reminds me that I don't need to have my stuff together to start my healing. Instead, it's a reminder to show up as I am with curiosity in hand, ready to take on whatever is in front of me on the page. It is a tool that reminds me that even in doubt, the work I need to do will meet me wherever I am. As I heal, I come to the page, raw and honest, and remember that I am not a victim of my thoughts. When I thought I couldn't get myself together enough to write this book, the pages of my journal allowed me to uncover not just my why, but also my why not. Clarity will always find us if we are curious and honest enough. But it won't be without struggle. Healing is slow and sacred work that we will all grapple with in our lifetimes. The more I explore my own healing, and the longer I teach writing to heal courses, the more I've discovered that trauma does not have to be our resting place. We can feel, address, and notice our pain without lying down in it and staying there. To me, that is what it means to walk through or alongside our healing, getting back up again whenever we stumble or fall. I used to think that was such a drag, not arriving at a destination of being healed, but the more I got to know myself and my pain points, the more I realized that what is necessary is choosing not to stay in the pit of my pain, looking at it for what it is, and using the tools I share here. There is no endpoint to healing. Healing in the wellness community is often talked about as an end goal. The messaging suggests that if we can just heal and get over it, whatever it is, all will be well and good. But healing does not mean that you won't experience more suffering or tenderness around the original thing that hurt you. Healing is a forever thing, or like I say to my clients and students, a constant reminder to love and care for ourselves, an invitation to nurture ourselves just like we would do everyone else. We heal to make space, to redefine ourselves and our narratives, to expand and become better, to forgive, create new possibilities and move forward, to build community and create bonds. We heal to release shame, manifest self-love, create autonomy, and begin again. We heal to redefine ourselves, face our fears, and develop self-trust. We heal to mend relationships and deepen connections with those around us. We heal to get free. Healing creates a healthy sense of togetherness in a way that misery and brokenness cannot. I know this to be true because I spent years of my life trauma bonding with people, and there was nothing healthy about that, for them or me. I was codependent and trapped in emotional confusion. Sometimes we heal to prove a point. There is often healing in the proving, changing, and having outsiders bear witness. There may be people in your life not ready to do their own healing work yet. But when they watch you change, break cycles, and start healing, it's almost like a permission slip of what's possible for their own lives. There were many people in my life who had not done their own healing, and they told me I'd be nothing but a broken teen mom with no life skills. Not only did I refuse to believe that, but I also worked hard not to be what people were hoping I'd be. I will not let outside projections break me. You may be the only one doing things differently in your family, or you may be the only one deciding to get emotionally free in your friend group. I know this can feel isolating, but do not ignore your healing because you're waiting for your loved ones to get on board. Take action, set boundaries, and do the work because you're the leader of your life and they're the leaders of theirs. Remember, you can love people deeply and still choose not to stay stuck in unhealthy patterns with them. Your self-healing can lead the way for onlookers. It's an open invitation for others to explore what healing can look like in their own lives. Healing is transformational and cyclical. Whether you have a broken arm or a broken heart, whatever is hurting, breaking, or crumbling must be tended to. Ignoring does not mend us. it causes rapid disintegration of our mind, body, and spirit. If we don't face what is hurting or aching, it will continue to break us down. I discovered that healing myself was an active choice of learning from my mistakes and remembering my worth. It takes effort. It requires consistently finding the sweet spot of mending for the moment. That's why I say this is a forever thing, a forever love, a marriage of sorts. Trusting that healing was an active choice that can be hard as hell gave me inner peace on the days that hurt the most. When I stopped chasing the idea that I would be forever healed after I healed the first time, the disappointment of not having a whimsical experience vanished. Remembering that I'm not broken, that I need to tend to the same thing that I thought I healed from already, offered me a sense of grace. In this audiobook, I invite you to join me on a healing journey, a journey of reconnecting with yourself and welcoming the joy that shows up at your door. My hope is that this audiobook provides you with the resources to create your own self-healing practice. This is an invitation to find what works and feels good for you. And even though healing can look and feel vastly different to each and every one of us, we all have something in common: the desire to live a life that is fulfilling and liberating, even when the going gets tough. Over the next few hours, I will guide you through a four-step healing process. In step one, we will tend to self-doubt and make room for new beginnings so that we are prepared to walk the path ahead. In step two, we will work on learning how to befriend our fear so that it no longer controls us. Step three offers lessons in reclaiming your power and rewriting your story with intention. And step four focuses on leaning into what feels good so that we can live with gratitude and joy. This four-step process is the same framework I've relied on in my own healing journey, and it's a process that has helped thousands of my workshop participants heal their hearts. Though healing is never linear, my hope is that following these steps will provide you with a foundation for healing, building blocks that you can return to again and again. Throughout each step, I will describe writing exercises for you to follow in a journal. Journaling is central to the work we'll be doing together. Maybe you're coming to this book thinking, "I'm not a writer," or "I've never been good at journaling." Leave those thoughts behind. Writing to heal is for everyone. Let your journal be your confidant, your companion, and your mirror. A safe place to fall apart.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.